The video you're about to watch is about some Yahoo Yahoo boys, and I want you to pay attention, be very, very attentive as you watch this video, because I want you to learn some things. And after today, you begin to keep some of the things that contains your personal information very, very well, ranging from your ATM card, your voter's card, your national identity card, even your CV. Because even your date of birth can be used to get another information that can lead to getting a bigger information about you. And most of you use your date of birth as your ATM pin. You only know that that close person next to you as your brother, as your cousin, as your friend. You do not really know that person, you know, what that person does behind the scenes. So you don't know. So that is why you have to keep those things save to yourself. They are called your personal biodata, your personal information. Only you should have access to them, except on rare cases when it is absolutely necessary to give it to the person, or, you know, give that person one or two informations about you. Another tip I want to give is that you have to password your SIM card. I don't mean passwording your phone. Password your SIM card. Before you do that, you have to know your POC number, personal unblocking key. If you don't know your POC number, don't password your SIM. Because if you mistakenly enter a wrong code into your SIM open it, it will block your SIM, and it will require you to impute your POC number, personal unblocking number, because that SIM controls so many things. Your SIM card is very, very important. It controls your financial transactions and so many of your deals, your business, especially if you're a business person or somebody that is inclined to online stuff. Your SIM card is a kind of gateway to another world of your success, or world of your investments, or, you know, depending on what you're doing. So that is why it's always very good and safe to password your SIM also. And if you password your SIM, even if you misplace your phone and somebody picks it, or somebody takes your phone and use without your knowledge, the person wouldn't have access to that SIM. Also, SIM cloning wouldn't be possible with it. And again, your WhatsApp should have a two-factor verification by now. If you're using a WhatsApp and it doesn't have two-factor verification, then you're doing yourself a great disservice, because that WhatsApp can be hacked. That WhatsApp can be cloned. Your account can be hacked anytime. Very, very easy to be hacked by anybody. So please, if you have gained anything from this video and you're yet to subscribe to our channel, why wouldn't you just do that right now and hit the notification bell? Great thanks to all of you, our returning subscribers. May Elohim bless each and every of you in Jesus' name.
I did a SIM transaction. So I did a SIM transaction over in last 2 weeks. So what really happened is that there was a guy caught somewhere. So he called me to come and check one account that he has a work for me at Togate, Ibadan. So when I get there, so he told me that the work had been with him over 4 days, that there's money on the account. So when I checked the account, I saw almost like 700,000 plus. So I told him that what took him so long before calling me. Okay, now I said that I just do anything I can do to get money. So that particular day, the person doesn't even have BVN on the SIM. So when I checked the BVN, he did not use the phone number to register BVN. So I checked the person's contact, maybe he saved the BVN. So he didn't save the BVN. So I was now thinking that maybe this BVN could be saved in the iCloud, or maybe the Yahoo Mail. So I had the iCloud, because I only asked for the email of the iCloud. So when I get the email, so I reset the password. After resetting the password, I checked the iCloud. I couldn't find the BVN, no contact on the iCloud. So my man just told me that I should go and check the Yahoo Mail, that it could maybe the victim could save the BVN on the Yahoo Mail. So when I had the Yahoo Mail, I saw the BVN. So when I got the BVN, so I just checked the BVN. When I checked the BVN with one software, so I got the details. After seeing the details, I registered the account. After I registered the account, so I just bought I bought a airtime of 1,000 to my line. That's actually what brought me here. So when I bought the airtime, I don't even believe that the pin have successfully be created. So when I check, I saw a message that your recharge of 1,000 is successful on my line. Wow, this work has been done. So I went to POS. I was now making a transfer. So after making a transfer, that guy called Samuel. And I told him that it was taking, maybe I took the money away. I don't want to give him any share. And I told him that the service of the Access Bank is no good at that moment, that maybe by 12 o'clock in the midnight that I could do the work. So I told him that he can't give me the work, that he's going to lodge me at hotel so that I will be able to do the work. So before 12, after 9 o'clock in the night, I checked the balance. When I checked the balance, no money is there. I was not thinking that what happened. But I later discovered that the owner of the account was the one that removed the money. So I was not, because I'm an artist, I was not looking for Instagram, because on the contact I saw that the person is using an Instagram account. So I was not thinking that maybe I should have the Instagram account. Maybe he have up to 15,000 followers that I could be using. So when I checked the Instagram account, I saw up to 600 followers. And I said that, okay, maybe the Instagram account could be, maybe I will be using it for baby, that they will be sending recharge cards to me, people on the followers. I first checked the first conversation. They came to our hospital to come and rob us last night, on Friday. The person replied again that, why don't you report to police? Then the person replied again, very soon they will be tracking the phone. Okay, and I told that someone, asked this my brother, I told them that this phone, very soon they will track this phone. So it's that day I left there. That's what brought me here.
Okay. How much did you transfer with your transfer?
80,000 plus.
To which account?
To POS. Because if I use my account, it can give me a problem. So I just went to POS that I want to make a transfer. I'll just buckle it. That's all.
Since
2019.
How much have you made from this?
Total money I've made.
Yes,
no, it's not every day. It's not every day, but I only advertise on Facebook that whenever I want a local wire, kindly DM me. It's not every day.
Local
wire. Yeah. So it's not every day. Once. But the highest money I've seen before is 500,000 naira.
And what did you use it to do?
I rent house.
Where do you live?
Ibadan.
So what do you need before you can have access to somebody's account?
Only the alert SIM, that's all.
Eh?
Only the alert SIM, that's all.
Alert SIM.
That's all, yeah.
So, don't look at alert, don't register alert.
What's your
in this work?
No. Did you go to school?
I don't go to school. SS2 with the shame.
Yes.
SS2. Best way to teach me, in Nigeria, in the Yankee, in the Dubai, now Dubai in the. So in just teach me only ATM with voters card. You know, some people they say if they get ATM, some people they use date of birth. So now, give me ATM. Now, I just go ATM point. I see 1979. I put on. I press on. Still balance.
If I give you my ATM card now,
that's
my consent.
Yes.
How old are you?
26 years.
Oyo
State. Ayola Olalekan.
So, can you tell us how it is easy for you to wire money from another person's account?
It's not up to 5 minutes, that's all.
How do you do it?
I don't want to say it. But only code with software, that's all.
Then you get the
software on phone.
Yeah, laptop and phone.
Maybe you just see the same.
That's my laptop.
You buy the software or you get it?
I create software myself.
Can you teach me?
Can you teach me? I can teach you now. It's simple.
Okay, you are the one that will create
software. Yes, by myself. I asked my organ.